So over time, domestic dogs has evolved to become progressively smaller, also has a more forehead. These prominent forehead is give you a more baby kind of a look, right?
More human-like.
Yeah, mm-hmm. yeah, it's more human-like, yeah. and the eye is more forward-looking mm-hmm. and larger. And the reason that we select these features is what we call the process of neonaty, the retarded growth of the species so that they actually mature early. So it means that we select individuals that are young and they are also cute compared to the big fierce wolves.
My name is Ronan Donovan, and today I'm at the Natural History Museum of Los Angeles County. I'm here to meet Dr. Xiaoming Wang. He's head of the Vertebrate Paleontology Department at the museum. And we're gonna look at some skulls and some specimens behind the scenes, behind the closed doors.
My name is Xiaoming Wang. I'm a curator. I've been here for 23 years. I'm here to show Ronan Donovan the mammalogy collection. It is very important to bring the public to the collection and to view the wonderful diversity that we have, to show our care about the natural world.
Collections like this have the ability to create these foundational data sets that allow for us to better understand how animals and species and variation has changed over time, which allows us to better understand speciation and animals that are changing in this environment that is going to continue to change.
My current research is heavily concentrated in the study of family canidae, the family of dogs, wolves, foxes and coyotes. They tend to balance the world of predators and prey. These animals has a very diverse, very long history in the past, particularly in North America. They literally evolved from here, and eventually they went on to give rise to all of the wonderful diversity of living canid.
There are two specimens, both canids, both wolf species, but one's a wild wolf, and then one is a domestic dog. They are still the same species, they're just subspecies variations. Dr. Wang was talking about how the domestication led to shrinking in skull sizes, and the sagittal crest, which controls bite force, was shrunk in domestic dogs, and thinking about that process and how it must have happened tens of thousands of years ago. I find it interesting just to look at the size difference, and then we can all think about like a wolf and a chihuahua and realize what we as humans creatively did, make variations of a wild animal, make variations of wolves. It's interesting, I spend most of my wolf-related work is around living animals, those that have personalities and families and social groups. And it's always interesting to think about holding a skull of a wolf or looking at a pelt. And my mind wonders about what it was like when it was hunting and traveling and playing. For me, that's the piece that I try to convey in the images, is the living part of wolves. And so when I look at these specimens, I'm always curious about what was their life like. The wolves photography exhibit, paired with the existing collection that the museum has, I think offers a really unique opportunity to contrast with the existing specimens that can go back millions of years. It gives people this complete idea of what this landscape and North America and other continents look like when canids were all over the place. Now thinking about where wolves and canids are today in this human-dominated world, I think it gives a whole idea about the human-canid relationship, past, present, and potentially what it would look like in the future.